Welcome to the Django project, DJ Blogger. This tutorial is part of a YouTube Django project playlist, which you can access in the video description. You can watch the whole course from the very beginning. If you enjoy this course and would like all the updated tutorials and associated code samples and more, you can check out this course and other courses this project features at Udemy. The link to the course is in the video description. Before we go into the next section, actually, let's make sure that we have created our pip requirements file. So in this tutorial, we're going to learn how to do that and the reason why we might want to do that. So far, we have been installing applications from the Python package index, and we have created our baseline here, our baseline project, our framework, our environment for testing and developing our application. So when we want to replicate this, we need to make sure that we have all the packages installed correctly. So for example, if I were to give you this code now, obviously it wouldn't work on your machine because you don't have all the packages installed that is needed. For example, Django. We install Django and we install Flake 8 and we install Black, for example. So we need to keep a record of that. So one way to do that is by utilizing the requirements file. We can ask pip to create that for us. So let's just clear that, move this up. So I type in pip and make sure we're in the virtual environment. So pip and then freeze and then the right chevron and then requirements. Now you can call this whatever you like, but requirements.txt. So that's going to create a new file and it's going to essentially collect all the packages that have been installed so far into a nice list here. And then if I were to share this code with you now, all that you would need to do in order to replicate this environment is run pip and then install and then R flag for requirements and then run the requirements file. And then pip would basically install all these packages back into your machine and then you can replicate where I am currently in this project. So once you've finished with that, the pip requirements, don't forget to save up. So let's commit this to our repository. And then I'm just going to type in NC down here. Your list here might be different to mine. I got out of sync here with making these tutorials. Apologies. But you should have something to commit potentially. So commit to your main and then push to the origin. And that will make all the changes needed. And we're currently up to date. We're now ready to move into the next section of the course.